Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. To kick off this video, there were a bunch of tweets from the NASA Commercial Crew account. The first says NASA and SpaceX are targeting no earlier than April 20th for the launch of the second crew rotation mission with astronauts to the space station. Next, they tweeted, Crew 2 is expected to arrive at the station to overlap with the astronauts that flew on NASA's SpaceX Crew 1 mission. The Crew 1 astronauts are scheduled to return in late April or early May. The Crew 2 astronauts will return in fall of 2021. As well as that, there was another tweet saying, Additionally, NASA and SpaceX continue preparations for the launch of the Crew 3 mission currently targeted for fall of this year. There's a tweet from space reporter Michael Sheets about the DOJ investigating a SpaceX hiring issue. The tweet says the DOJ is investigating SpaceX over whether it engages in any pattern or practice of discrimination in its hiring after a complaint last year. In another tweet, he quotes this from the DOJ during the charging party's interview for the position of Technology Strategy Associate, SpaceX failed to hire him for the position because he is not a US citizen or lawful permanent resident. What's worth noting though is that ITAR laws prevent SpaceX from hiring non-US citizens. Musk has previously said that there is a lot of talent out there that can't be hired because of the ITAR laws, as what SpaceX is building is considered an advanced weapon technology. There's a new article about SpaceX funding which says Elon Musk's rocket company SpaceX could be valued at a minimum of $60 billion as it finalizes a funding round expected to close in February, Business Insider reported on Thursday, citing three people familiar with the matter. It also says the latest round is expected to price each share between $325 and $350, the report said. There's also another article, this one from CNBC, about SpaceX looking to get people on board for new versions of Starlink satellites. The article says SpaceX is preparing to begin production of the next generation of its Starlink internet satellites, according to a company job posting, with the company having deployed more than 1,000 first-generation satellites into orbit to date. It also says a posting on the company's careers page open at the time of publishing on Friday says SpaceX is looking to hire a lead software engineer for Starlink hardware testing, specifically to define and lead the test software roadmap for Starlink version 1.5 and version 2 production. Taking a look at some Boca Chica bits, here's a great aerial view of the orbital launch pad thanks to Jack Beyer. SpaceX have received a new delivery with an unknown component. The old Gaswell lot area is coming together as they work on a new liquid oxygen distiller. I thought I'd share another article to do with some stuff Gwynne Shotwell said recently. It says, Shotwell noted SpaceX's ambitious hopes for the future. In 10 years we'll see people start settling on other planets, adding that people tell us we are crazy every day but we need to ignore that and push forward. We are trying to find a breakthrough in propulsion technology that allows us to go beyond the moon, beyond Mars, beyond the entire solar system. Certainly within 50 years we'll have a path that will allow us to fly to other worlds. There was a tweet posted with an animation of Lunar Starship launching. Musk gave a response and said, "For us to wait will be approximately 1.5 so it will accelerate unusually fast. High thrust to weight is important for reusable vehicles to make more efficient use of propellant, the primary cost. For expendable rockets, throwing away stages is the primary cost, so optimization is low thrust to weight." Trevor Marlman posted some amazing 425 megapixel shots of SN9. Musk responded and said, "Major aesthetics improvements coming." Another delivery was spotted in the yard with the arrival of this Starship flap. SpaceX were expected to launch SN9 multiple days during the week and were let down multiple times. With all the FAA delays, Musk got quite annoyed and posted a tweet in response to Chris B at NSF. He said, "Unlike its aircraft division, which is fine, the FAA space division has a fundamentally broken regulatory structure. Their rules are meant for a handful of expendable launches per year from a few government facilities. Under those rules, humanity will never get to Mars." On Thursday, when we were hoping for a flight, reporters were trying to find out more information from the FAA. Christian Davenport posted a tweet saying, "Statement from the FAA just now, read a SpaceX flight. We will continue working with SpaceX to resolve outstanding safety issues before we approve the next test flight." On Thursday, SpaceX even started fueling Starship before it detanked sometime later. Another tweet, this one from reporter Joey Roulette, mentions why the FAA is taking so long with the review. He said SpaceX's SN8 Starship test last month violated its FAA launch license, triggering an investigation and heaping extra regulatory scrutiny on future Starship tests. The FAA is taking extra steps to make sure SN9 is compliant. Michael Sheets also posted about something said in a statement from the FAA. It says, "We will approve the modification only after we are satisfied that SpaceX has taken the necessary steps to comply with regulatory requirements." SpaceX have updated their website to include information about the next SN9 attempt, confirming they are hoping to launch it Monday, February 1st. Cameron County have posted some new road and beach closures for the upcoming testing. There's a primary date of tomorrow, Monday 1st, with backups on Tuesday and Wednesday. So, once again, the SN9 flight to 10 kilometers should hopefully happen tomorrow. On Friday, after the FAA said no to a flight of SN9, SpaceX decided to roll SN10 out to the pad instead. With SN10 now rolled out to the pad to join SN9 as it awaits approval from the FAA, Jack Beyer posted a photo. He tweeted it with the caption saying, "Looks like no Raptors are currently installed on Starship SN10. Musk responded and confirmed the plan for SN10 by saying, "Cryoproof, then install engines." I want to share this amazing shot of the SN10 rollout with SN9 sitting on Pad B, posted by Elon Musk. He then also tweeted later in the day an amazing sunset shot of SN10 being lifted and workers on Pad A waiting to guide it. You should also note, as pointed out by Pauline Ackerlin, that this shot was taken by photographer John Krause and not Elon Musk himself. SN11's nose cone is now stacked with the barrel section to form the fairing. Super Heavy booster number 1 was seen being lifted as the tank comes together at a faster pace now. Finally, we have the latest Starship and Super Heavy prototype status diagram thanks to Brendan Lewis. The fleet of test vehicles is coming together nicely. As always, I have to thank Mary or Boca Chica Girl for capturing the amazing stuff going on in Boca Chica. Also, thank you to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on the videos, live streams, and other space content. There's also some really cool content from other people out there photographing what's been going on in the build-up to SN9's flight. Great work by them too. That's it for this episode of The SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.